Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Pete and we're going on with a Optimus Prime build. I've just put out a little short on YouTube to show that I'm doing this and it will be online soon. I don't know how long we're going to take over it, but we are going to do it. And have you see on the slide camera, you see the pack set ready and it's numbered from 10 to 15, even 15, 10 to 15. But it's three packs as usual, and it's numbered that way, but it's one thing. So let's go straight into it. I've got the packs, the tray numbers and so on, so I know which number is which. And let's go straight into it and start this beautiful build. So we're gonna start with tray number one, as you see right there. This is tray number one, and we're starting with these parts and we're going to go to those parts afterwards. These are the first things we're going to put together, right like that, and we're going to put two of those TR 2x14 screws. So these are the only PB screws, but they're on the packet it says 2.3x6, and we're going to put a little bit of, we're going to get the glue out because we're going to get that end out, put that end on as you can see right there. And now we're going to do the same thing for this one. This one. That little pipe. And let's see, it doesn't stay on. So we're going to put a little bit of glue on as well. So that is what we have. We're going to take that one out, but we're going to mind the little gap that is there, because that needs to go over that. And it goes on quite easily. As you can see, it moves around quite easily. Then we're going to get that one out. Now let's see which side goes where. That little indent has to go up, so that's up a little bit higher. There is a little bit of glue in there. We're taking that beautiful piece out, but we are going to put something down because I don't want it to be scratched. And I think we're going to pack 15 and we're getting that one out, and we're pushing it in. As you can see right there, that's not coming out, but they want us to put a little bit of glue on that. Don't overdo the gluing thing. That is superb. Then we're going to put this on like so, and we're going to put a screw in from underneath, which is a PB 2.6 still. They've got the numbers right here, it seems to be. Well, that was in there loose, so that's fine. This is what we have. So we're going to put this aside and get that one out. And we're going to put that one to the side, and we're going to change over to this one, which is a Torx screw. So we're putting that split ring on, then the washer. Then we're putting on this side, not on that side. And we're twisting it on one side. And then we're holding it like so, and we do that four times. So let's finish that off. So we've got that. Then we're going to get that one out. I think we're putting it on, doesn't matter which way, it's the same. So we're pushing that on like so. It's hard to put in the same thing. So with split ring, washer, and in this case the 3x8 screw, and we're putting four of those on. So let me finish that and come back to you. So we've put those in, and if you see, that stops it from going any further. Now we're gonna go to this side, and we're gonna be putting on one of those on this side. And this is where we get the smaller 2.6, but we're still getting a split ring. And we do that four times. And this is what it looks like then. Thanks for telling me. I should have done that beforehand, because there are lines that you have to take care of, but they've only showed it afterwards. That's not very smart. Okay. If you look very closely, and I don't know if I can show you, you can see that there are flat ends, flat sides right there and on the opposite side, and they should be aligned with that. It doesn't show this time what the alignment should be, but I'm making it flat with those sides, so that flat side of the screws are on this side and on that side, and I'm making sure that they come together with that. So I've put them all in, as you can see, and what I did not tell you, these are this is an Allen key, more or less, or at least a bit. We do get an Allen key with it, but I think this is so much better. Hexagonal screw head. All right, we're getting that one out. I think we are going to put it on here. And it's not clear whether or not we put it all the way on over that slot, because we do have an outtake there. I think it does mean that we've got it like that. Yeah, this is the second time they only tell you right at the end what it should be. 14, the long ones. This four of the very long ones. And we do put split rings in there as well. It's a very big joint here, but yeah. We all know that Optimus Prime is one of the larger partware builds that is around. So that is what we have. Quite a hefty joint of some sort. As you can see right there, it's pretty darn strong. And I think this is step 11. And as you can see here, this should be aligned with the screw that is behind it, and I've done it right, as I said, that I aligned the screw flat sides to these, and I've done correct. I think they should have put that right at the moment that we screw them in, and not when we screw it in and have to go back all the way to correct it. Yeah, I'm a little bit in concentration mode doing this. But that is what we've just put on with two of those PB 2.3x6. Wow, we're going to put it onto this. And I think I've got the orientation right. And then we're putting PM 2x. They can only be these with split rings. This is a little bit strange. I want a bit of oil because it's going into plastic. Metal, sorry. Don't over tighten it straight away. So we've got those in already with those split rings and PB, what was it? PM's 3x8. So that's in properly with those four screws that you see right there and right there. And we're gonna glue again. And we're gonna get those out. And I think, except for the Allen key, that is tray number one done. So we're going to put them together like so. I'm not going to push them in because I probably can't get them out, because I do need to put some screws in first. And those are the 2.3x6 screws. Those are into plastic, so no need for a little bit of oil or anything like that. What I've done, I've put a bit of glue on all those points. Now we're going to put it on like so, and as you can see, that whole joint is in there, and it looks there's a little metal specks. It looks like that they're in there, but that is neatly in there, as you can see. All right, we're going to tray number two. They're going over this area and off to those points we put together with that. You cannot put it in any other way, because it's neatly into this piece of metal here. Then we put four 2.3x6 screws in here. We're doing the same. So I've put them in. 1, 2, 3, 4. I should show it to you like that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Those 2.3x6 screws, and we're going to put them on again. Like so, and that is in as well. Step 16, we're going to put this aside, we're going to get that one out, and we're going to put, I think it's this one in, 229, two of those black screws. Those are the 2.3x6 screw. Have a good look at the orientation that I have here. Then we're going to get those big screwy things in. Put those in with the smaller screw down, and this is what is fitting in here. Then we're going to get this one in, and that fits in there. No, the other way around. And then we're going to put the other one over and screw the whole thing together. Yep, turn it around. One, two, three screws in. We're still staying with those black screws. That is where it should be when we're done. So we're pushing that one with the very large screw thing over that one there. And then this one is the number two. Where does number two? Yeah, you know the thing. And we're going to put those together, and we're going to put a screw, no, on this side, a nut. There it is. Then a split ring and 2.3. There's not much left. It's like catching or trying to catch a fish, but it's in there. Then we've got this rubber ring to go around this part. So I've tried to move that around, but it's really hard. But it will get easier. And then we're getting those two out. Is there a certain way to put it on? I think they're copies of each other. And we're putting them on like so, with that top away from the shoulder arm. Okay, don't know. And then we're putting the other one on the other side, of course. And I've put it in, almost put it in wrong. As you can see, that should be like that. And then we're going to put some nuts on this side. And then some still of those. There we go. That's on with screws and those hexagonal. Yep, we're going to that one. And I don't see that it should be in a certain way. So we're going to put it over. And I've laid a little mistake, but it can be undone by twisting it. Because those, compared to the nuts, have to be a certain way. Yeah, so we're going to tighten them up again, and then we're going to put them on again. Like so. With the screws on this side. Oh, this one is not going to be easy. I don't know if this works, but this may be a little trick to keep those nuts in. Otherwise you're going nuts because you're losing those nuts all the time. Well, that worked. So that's a little trick you may do when you're putting in nuts and you can't, there's so many and you can't hold them. Use a bit of masking tape so they don't fall out when you go to the other sides to screw these wonderful screws in. There we go. We can take that off as well. And then we've got all those nuts in, screwed in properly. So I just needed a dry fit because I didn't see what the picture meant. These parts are going onto, can you see those slots there? But you need to go under that with the nuts that are sticking out. And then we're going to do something really nice as well, because we're probably going to put some nuts underneath these. Yep, this ain't going to be easy. These are not easy to put in, guys. Okay, what I can say about, let me just do that right there, about the screws that we have to put underneath, and the nuts especially, these are the hardest ones for there to put it. You slide them in, but the best thing is to slide them in, to by hand screw them in, and then tighten it up, because that's the easiest way to keep it all together. We're getting that panel out. And we're putting it over like so. And we've got screws to put in on those sides. And there are probably the black screws to put in. They are probably the black screws, and I was right. And they're not saying whether or not the louvers or the have to go either way, because they're both the same. All right, we're gluing. I'm leaving it here so you can enjoy it. We're leaving that for a second, and we're getting this one out. We're holding this for a second because it was in quite wobbly, and I'm holding it like that, but pushing it in. Okay, now we're getting to where we know, and this is where we use those PWNs. So I'm dropping them in, then I can screw them in. So if you look at those, whatever is cooling, it should come out at an angle to the back. I'll show you in a moment. So we're screwing in. I can't point it out on that camera because I can't see that camera. We're screwing in right there and there, and of course on the opposite side as well. These two we're putting together. And it's a number one here, and on that plate is a number one as well, so you know you've got the right one. And the PWs. All right. So we've got the one side. I think this is the one side. This is how they're holding it. And have a look at that. Those points, we can slide them in with those. So we put them down a little bit, then push them up, as you just saw me do that. It's a good quality build, guys, really. 2.3 × 6, that's that. And in that one only. Yep. The one with the hole. Yep. And we're gonna put that to the side again because we're building something again. We've got this one from tray 2 and that one from tray 3. And that you cannot put it in any other way. There we go. It needs to be pushed in on the side here, that one, because it will not work otherwise. 2.4, this one. And 2 × 4, and we're putting it right there. And we're gonna put a little bit of glue on the points that we are gonna put in, because we're gonna put it in like so. Like so, we're gonna put that in, but we need to put a bit of glue on that. There we go. That is on as well. Let's see where we go next. Okay, we're gonna put this to the side. Let's put this on that so it pushes down. So we're gonna take that one out. 12 is 1, 13 is 2. So 13 should be on this side and 12 on this side. Looks quite all right. Then we're gonna put some 2.4s in there. Wobble check. Then we're probably gonna get it in and put it on. Like so, as you saw me do that. It just put it down there and then push it in. We get 2.3 × 6 screw out. I make that mistake every single time. There we go, that's on. Then we get that little thingamajig on. Have a good look at that orientation, because one slot's there and one slot's just around the armpit. And then we're gonna put the emblem on right there. That's not gonna come off, so I'm gonna leave it. If we lose it, it's there. It's not no problem. So we've got that on. Forget to do something because I haven't got that on anywhere. And these are the large parts. Okay. That's peculiar. This is a 2x6. It seems that I'm a screw short. This one seems to do the trick, but agorimals, I was a screw short. Well, last thing we do, we glue. Because this is the last thing we do, and that's when this pack, this beautiful pack of this massive arm is done. And that is that, well, at least I call this shoulder and upper arm done. This is this arm done, the left arm. So this is it, that is this big arm. And on the picture here, you can see it is this side that we've just made of this big, massive Optimus Prime build. And I love doing it. It is a proper quality build. I've not seen the quality of build of any builds as this one yet. So really happy with it. Please like, subscribe, and pass it on, and join me next time when I do some more on this one or any of those in the back. See you next time. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.